Welcome students. So in today's lecture we shall be starting with a new topic of trial balance. In the previous lecture we had completed the books of original entry, the journal, and the books of secondary entry, the ledger. So now let us start with the trial balance. So before preparing the financial accounts or the final accounts, it is necessary to test the accuracy of the individual posting. Under the double entry bookkeeping system that has two aspects, debit and credit of each transaction must be recorded. So a trial balance is simply a check to verify whether the postings are done correctly. So now let us write the definition of a trial balance. It is a statement prepared to check the arithmetical accuracy of bookkeeping entries up to the date stated at the head of the trial balance. So it ensures that both the aspects of each transaction have been duly recorded. So it basically ensures that the debit and credit sides are balanced. So it is necessary to total the amounts of finances. So what are the various objectives? So now let us start with the objectives of trial balance. So the various objectives of trial balance are: number one, to ascertain the arithmetical accuracy of ledger accounts. So this is the first objective. So this helps to ascertain that the sum of debit and credit columns of the trial balance tally, and it is assumed that the posting in the ledger account have been made correctly. So if the debit and credit sides are balanced, it ensures that the entries are accurately posted. However, the individual ledger accounts are also accurate since the following errors which I am going to mention in the ledger accounts are not revealed by the trial balance. So it has certain limitations also. So what are the limitations? Number one is, it cannot identify the wrong entry in ledger. Second, omission entries are not identified. Then posting of entries or transactions in wrong columns cannot be identified also. And finally, the posting of correct amount but to a wrong account, so they can also be not identified. So all these entries are not identified in trial balance. Now the next objective is To help in locating the error, so when there are a large number of postings in a ledger, the trial balance does not tally. The following steps are required to be taken to locate the possible errors. So first of all, recheck of the tally of debits and credits. So recheck the debit and credit entries. Next, the recheck of trial balance items of the ledger. Then recheck of items in trial balance with the ledger accounts. The number of items should match. Then the balancing of ledger accounts should be done in order to avoid any kind of inconvenience by posting. And then to check the ledger folio in journal if any entry is omitted. So this helps to locate the various errors that are occurring. Then comes the third objective, which is to help in preparation of final accounts. So it also helps in preparation of final accounts. So how the final accounts are prepared? The trial balance contains the list of all the ledger accounts with their debits and credit balances. So while preparing the final accounts, that are the financial statements, there is no need to refer the ledger. So it acts as, we can say, the trial balance itself acts as source document for preparation of financial statements. Similarly, the trading account and profit and loss accounts can also be prepared from the revenue and expenses accounts appearing in the trial balance. So these are the various objectives that help to prepare the trial balance. Now, what are the various methods of preparation of a trial balance? So now we shall be writing the methods of preparation of trial balance. So the various methods that help to prepare the trial balance. The first method that is used is known as the balance method itself. So in the balance method, all the ledger accounts are first balanced. So in this method, all the ledger accounts are first balanced. So these balanced accounts are serving as an immediate source for posting into the trial balance. For this purpose, the debit and credit sides of each ledger account. So how these are balanced? So the debit and credit side of each ledger account is totaled first, and the balance on both sides, that are debit and credit, is obtained. These balances are then recorded on the debit and credit side of the trial balance. So how, what is the format of this trial balance? So I will be writing here, the trial balance as on, or we can simply write the date format here, so the date has to be mentioned. So then a format is to be prepared. So this is generally done on the loo sheets. So three columns are usually given in this. So the first column is the particulars that contains the ledger accounts, then the balances. So the balance on the debit and credit side. So it is prepared on the loo sheet. The first column gives the name of the account, and the second and third column shows the amount of debit and credit respectively. So here the various accounts such as sales, cash, building, salaries, so they all are entered here, and finally a total is to be taken on the debit and the credit side, and both these totals have to be mentioned here. So if these values tally with each other, then our trial balance is accurate. So the second method that is involved in preparation of trial balance is known as total amounts method. So in this method, the total on debit side of every ledger account is entered. So I am writing here, the total on debit side of every ledger account is entered under debit column, and the total on credit side of each ledger account is recorded under credit column. So basically no balancing is to be done here, whereas in this balance method the accounts are first balanced. So this is the main difference that is there. A grand total of both debit and credit side is then taken, and it has to be tallied with each other to check the accuracy. So if there is a difference between the debit and credit side, it raises a question mark on the accuracy as well as the posting, and thus a rechecking is required. So the format for this is like this: the trial balance on, we will have to mention the date on which the trial balance is prepared, and then three columns are prepared just like the previous one, but here is there is a small difference. The first one is the particulars. It is a head for every ledger account. Then comes the two columns, simply the debit totals and the credit totals. So ultimately the totals of all the accounts is mentioned, and it helps to check the accuracy of the trial balance. So now there are some of the accounting errors as well. So what are these accounting errors? So now let us see what are the various accounting errors that may arise in the trial balance. So the first one is error of commission. So in the error of commission, it occurs due to wrong posting or wrong totaling or wrong balancing. Either the amount or on the wrong side of an account is recorded, or either in the wrong account. This is known as the error of commission. So it is also known as the clerical error or the clerical mistake. So these are generally committed by the staff, accounting staff, while recording the transactions in the books of ledger. So for example, if we have to record a transaction of rupees 10,000 in an account XYZ, but instead of that we recorded 1,000 rupees in account XYZ. So this is known as the error of commission. The next error is the errors of omission. Such errors occur if the transaction is omitted to be recorded either entirely or partly in the books of errors. So these are the missed transactions that are either omitted completely or entirely or partly. So the omission errors, if they are entirely missed out, then it poses no effect. Whereas the partial omission causes variation in accuracy of trial balance. So the third type of error is the error of principle. So this type of error occurs when there is a mistake in allocating a particular receipt or expense to a capital or revenue account. So if entries are recorded in wrong account, we cannot say a wrong account, but we can say that are not allocated properly. This may arise due to the confusion of the nature of the two accounts, such as we can say the capital and the revenue accounts, they are having somewhat similar nature. So sometimes it's difficult to check on which account we have to put the entry. So however, this the trial balance remains unaffected by such errors. So there is no effect on trial balance of such errors. But it affects the practices of maintaining the financial record. The fourth error is the errors of posting. Now here comes the entries of wrong account. So when posting is done to a wrong account, though with the correct amount on correct side, it is known as the errors of posting, and they also have no effect on the accuracy of trial balance because the amounts are posted correctly on the correct sides. And the last type of errors are the compensating errors. So these compensating errors, when two or more errors, we can say, when two or more errors are committed in such a manner that they nullify the effect of each other, and the debit and credit sides remains unaffected. So such errors are known as compensating errors, and they also pose no effect on trial balance. But however, the ledger accounts are affected badly. So students, this was all regarding the trial balance. So we have covered about the objectives of trial balance, then the methods of preparing the trial balance, and finally the accounting errors. So I hope now the trial balance is clear to you all.